actually used to have recurring dreams of flying.
Traffic congestion is rising. This is happening everywhere. This is happening in suburbs. This is happening in major urban areas everywhere. Most of the street infrastructure in the country was built 1910s or 1930s model that no longer fits the city it's in. Now we not only have more cars, but they're bigger. The biggest hurdle with all these things is the people. But it comes to a critical mass once people are so fed up with it that things start to change.
From science fiction, for decades, we've been promised a personal flying machine or a flying car. And people have been trying and failing. We are on the cusp technologically to make this happen. You're gonna be able to decide, do I wanna drive my own car into work today, or do I want a flying option? As a kid, I actually used to have recurring dreams where if I could jump high enough, right, and if I just had enough will, I would take flight in my dream. We're developing a personal vertical takeoff and landing aircraft. And the aircraft will be classified as an ultralight, which means no pilot's license is required to fly. With lift, we're not trying to solve the problem of flying long distances. We're really focused on where we believe the biggest problem is, which is very short hop flights in dense urban areas.
There's three very major costs right now for mankind with congestion. The first is an economic cost. Just here in New York, congestion will cost New York City around $100 billion. Most important in my mind is the environmental cost. The United Nations released a report that said that our transportation choices are now the leading cause of carbon emissions. It leads to the third cost, which I think there's a huge health cost with congestion. Congestion leads to higher asthma rates, more traffic fatalities, which are on the rise right now again after years of decline. There is an existential crisis from congestion. One of the ways that urban planners and urban designers are thinking of getting around the congestion problem is something called multimodality. What that means is that we have numerous ways of getting around, and all this would be shared. You know, I can get on the subway, bus, having numerous options. Aviation fits in that way.
We envision you being able to open your Lyft aircraft app and see real-time pricing and available aircraft, and then hop in one of our aircraft and fly from your neighborhood to another base near where you work. When you request a certain flight plan, that's going to sort of create a corridor for you. And then, of course, each aircraft is networked to other aircraft, so they all know where each other are. We can bring the cost per 10-mile trip down to around $20.
At its core is a basic hex copter. This one has 18 motors, though, so it's considered an octodecacopter. Being a hex configuration, we have three motors on each arm. They all counter-rotate. Each arm counter-rotates to compensate for torque.
So we have 18 propellers powered by 18 electric motors. Each has its own independent battery pack. This is a very far out, you know, future forward business, and it's incredibly high risk.
Forecast looks mostly the same, if not a little bit here.
We occasionally get 747s through here. Yeah.
So the objective for today's test flight is to take the vehicle as it is and put it through a series of tests where we change the center of gravity.
You get some funny looks when you tell people you're building a personal electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, a flying car, right? Because, you know, nobody's been successful doing this.
Henry Ford had this quote that said, if people asked me how I can go faster than a horse, they would have just asked for a faster horse rather than a car. So people can't imagine what they haven't seen yet and or don't know what that would be like. It takes a while for people to get used to transit and changes in transit.
The entire airframe is made out of carbon fiber, which is one of the lightest and strongest materials on the planet. We used a pretty big 3D printer and directly 3D printed the mold for this first pre-production aircraft. The average commutes range from 7 to 10 miles and take anywhere from 50 minutes to over 90 minutes. Our aircraft will go about 60 miles an hour, and you don't have to traverse a route confined by roads in a two-dimensional space. So you get to fly 10 miles in 10 minutes. A lot of the safety is going to come from flying in controlled airspace. Every obstacle, obstruction, power line, we are going to have everywhere we fly geospatially mapped. Each aircraft is networked to other aircrafts. We segment airspace immediately around the aircraft. If we had two pilots that tried to fly the aircraft and collide, you know, your joystick would not move the aircraft to crash into the other aircrafts.
A main concern with aviation and, you know, a lot of small-scale operations, and by small-scale I mean, you know, singular, one person, is that they don't do a major dent in mass transit. And I would counterpoint that by saying you might have one mode that takes 1,000 people out of cars every single day, but when you have 10 modes that take 1,000 people out each, now you have 10,000 people that are no longer using cars. So having numerous modes, aviation being one of them, that's when you really start to see an impact, and I think that's how it could function in a larger transit landscape.
Cover check. As you know, so we're going to go about 10 feet and see if we have any oscillations or anything like that. But have a good flight. See when you get on the ground.
Copy that. Thanks, Trips.
I think in 10 to 20 years, we're going to have many different types of aircraft in the sky, and you're going to have many different choices.
When cars first came out, cars were seen as threats. They were seen as toxic. They were seen as dangerous. And then cars took over America. And I think that's what would happen, but with numerous different kinds of modes of transit. You would have people at first very worried, and then they wouldn't be thinking about it because they'd be using it every single day and access 15 or 20 different options, all of which are sustainable and economically viable.